Hey guys, thanks for joining me this week for My Favorite Things. Super excited to be sharing these special books with you all week long. And today is our last day. So I figured I would focus on something that I tend to forget to highlight as much as I should. So for this video, I'm going to highlight some of my favorite picture books. These are books that, again, I tend to forget to show because there are just so many, it's hard to really narrow it down. So you've probably seen individual videos of these titles, but not too many of them all squished together to show you which ones I really love. So without further ado, here are my favorite picture books. So we've got All Better, a classic reusable sticker book. If you don't have this one, you need it. It is precious. Little reusable stickers. They're very durable, long lasting. I've had this copy for over a year. It's my personal copy. I use it all the time because I love this one. And the new one, the sister book, Little Bear Needs Glasses. Same idea, reusable stickers. This one has a sheet that actually comes out with the stickers on it. As you can see, I use this one a lot. The stickers are already placed on Little Bear there. Trying on some glasses. So this one's a really fun little picture book with a little bit of activity added in. So those two reusable sticker books. And then, of course, American Lee. I do absolutely adore this one. It's been one of my favorites since it came out in January. It's the sister book to Animalee, if you have Animalee. It's a rhyming, kind of sing-songy story that leads you all the way through the 50 states of America. All the big landmarks and national parks, Statue of Liberty, just really fun things. This one's great for families that like to travel, families that move a lot, like ours. I just love this book for that reason. It just talks about some of the greatest things about America. So it's a really cute one, a good bedtime story with still some factual information inside, which is always nice. And then Cordelia, love Cordelia. We're redheads, so we have to stick together. Michelle Nelson Schmidt is one of our fabulous authors. This is one of her books. All of her books are very inspiring stories. They all have some kind of underlying tone. This one, you know, Cordelia, is kind of told, you can't fly, you can't do that, you're a person, people don't fly. And she proves everybody wrong. So that's kind of her theme with her books. They all have some great, like bigger picture story to them. Jonathan James and the What If Monster is another one that's great, helping kids overcome fear. And her pictures are so great. She illustrates all these herself. So really fabulous books, Cordelia. And then our padded picture books. I love these. We have some that are like the classics. We have like a Cinderella and a Snow White. And then this one, How the Rhino Got His Skin, is actually one of Rudyard Kipling's stories. He's the guy that wrote The Jungle Book. So if you're familiar with his stories, they're all kind of karma based, I guess. They talk about, not karma totally, but this one happens to be kind of karma. But some of them, they just have a bigger picture story, kind of teach a lesson style. But I really like these. They're all fabulously illustrated. The new one for June is The Elves and the Shoemaker, which I'm looking forward to getting. I love these, they're really fun. Another new one that just came out, Pandemonia. This one I'm pretty obsessed with. It is just a really silly book. Kind of rhymey and sing-songy. You can kind of like sing your way through it. The illustrations are cute. It's in a zoo, so it goes over tons of animals. And I'm not gonna lie to you, I had to look up some of the animals that were listed in this book because I was like, I don't even know what that is. So I looked it up to see what they looked like so I could really get a better picture for it. So this would actually be a really good teaching tool along with just being a fun picture book for your kids if you have to go look up some of the animals and kind of find out more about them. But it's really cute. It's all about not waking the panda when you're at the zoo because then we have Pandemonia. So really a cute play on words here. And then my newly discovered love, Billy's Adventures. I really like these. They're short and sweet. There's kind of a little inspirational story behind each one where, you know, Billy has to kind of overcome something or get out of her comfort zone, something like that. So they're really cute. The illustrations are cute, very colorful, almost like a watercolor coloring style. There's tons of these. They're actually going to be available in a collection here soon, so that's awesome. Really excited about that. This one is the outer space one, by the way. There are two new ones, this one and Animal Hospital. Of course, I can't leave out Muddle and Match. I don't know if these are technically a picture book. I think they are, but they are kind of like All Better and Little Bear Needs Glasses. They are picture books with interactive features, so that's what we'll call them, but they still fall under the picture book category. So these are super fun mix and match books. They make a silly character and a silly story when you mix them up, or you can just read them in order, and they're alliteration that will get you nice and tongue-tied, but there's just endless possibilities with the mixing and matching on these, so I love that part. Tons of these. This is a new one, Hip and Hop. I am really excited for you guys that this one's out now, and it is kind of a 90s style hip-hop rap text with some great 90s style graffiti graphics illustrations. Really cool. We got to hear about this one at convention, and I'm just really excited to see what the kids think of this one, because I think it's really cool, but I'm anxious to see if they are going to take to the 90s style, like I hope they will. But it's just really cute. It's kind of, it's got a little storyline behind it too, so it's not just fun, but definitely not a bedtime story with this one. Very active and energetic, get your kids jumping up and down, really excitable kind of book. Okay, next up, Ludwig the Space Dog. This one is another new one. I showed this one a little while back. It's got 3D glasses in this pocket, and the whole book is 3D, even the cover. So it's really cute. It's all about Ludwig and his friends, and they're made out of paper, and they know that they're kind of stuck in their book, but they really want to go out and explore the world. So in this case, they want to go into space and explore. So they're trying to find a way to get off the page and into outer space. So it's really cute, just a fun story with the added feature, again, added bonus features in our picture books of 3D graphics and 3D glasses that come with it. So super fun on that one. And lastly, two favorites, Nibbles. We've got Nibbles, the original. So OG original Nibbles here, one of my first Usborne books, is a classic Usborne picture book. Everybody loves Nibbles. He's a mischievous little thing. He likes to get into things. He likes to eat books. He eats holes in my books and escapes through all the different stories. Just really fun. Again, kind of interactive with this one too. You kind of notice that theme if you've been hanging around here long enough. Most of our books are interactive in some way. So that is the classic Nibbles, and in the end, he escaped. And so now we have a new Nibbles. This is Nibbles Dinosaur Guide. This one just came out. Super, super excited about this one. Everybody is expecting that they are gonna keep continuing the Nibbles saga as he escapes all of his books. They can throw him into a new one, have a new story come out. So I'll keep you updated on that. We haven't heard anything specific on that yet, but I would not be surprised if there are more Nibbles books in our future. This one, obviously, he jumped into a dinosaur guide book, and he's gotten himself mixed up with all these dinosaurs. So if you've got dinosaur lovers and Nibbles lovers, this is a great one. And then he escapes at the end. So really super cute. But those are my favorite picture books. Sorry, this video is so long. But like I said, it's really hard for me to condense how many from all of these that I just really love. So I hope you guys got a little bit out of that. I hope you've enjoyed this week of my favorites. I'd love to hear your favorites. So if you would please comment below, tell me your favorite Usborne book. I know, it's really hard. I got a whole week to tell you mine, so if you can't come up with one, give me your top two or three. I'd love to hear them. Love to hear what your kids are into. And, you know, I love hearing their different personalities and what each one likes versus what the other one likes. So definitely let me know your favorites, and thank you for hanging out with me this week. Hope you guys have a wonderful holiday weekend, long weekend with friends and family, lots of relaxation and good food. And I will see you back here next week for some more great things to come. Bye, guys.